What's up, party people? Greetings and salutations from the Disney Character Warehouse on International Drive. My name is Ichabod Bones, aka the Incognito Mouse, but you can call me Icky. So we're going to go into the warehouse here in a minute and do some shopping, but first I just wanted to give you a quick update on the Disney job. So yesterday I went down to the Walt Disney World Casting Center, which is where they do all their hiring, right near Disney Springs, right next to the Grapefruit parking garage, if you've ever been there before. I had got an email to be there at a certain time, and basically this is what's known as the onboarding process, getting all your paperwork done and getting in. So I went into the casting center, which is a beautiful, beautiful place, by the way. I did not take any pictures or any video because I was afraid. I don't want to get in trouble. But I have seen other people take pictures in front of it. I've even seen people take videos inside of it. If you ever want to see it, just go on YouTube and look up, you know, Walt Disney World Casting Center and look at some videos. It's really beautiful inside there. Ornate hallways with paintings, and just they have this one room with marble floor and a rotunda type dome. Beautiful, beautiful place. But anyway, went in there, followed the cast member's directions to the place I needed to go, to this one suite for onboarding. Went into a room that looked basically like a Disney-fied DMV. Seats and little queue lines with the stretchy poles. Got in line, got up to the front. The lady said, yeah, hello, welcome to Disney. What role are you going to be joining us for? Whatever, may I see your ID? So I gave her my license and my social security. She took it down, said, all right, have a seat over there, and so will call you up in a few minutes. So I thought I was like at the DMV. Just so happened that I went in on the same day that all of the college program kids were coming in, the first day of college program. So there were hundreds and thousands of college kids from all over the country coming in to check in for their college program assignment. So it was busy, busy. I picked the wrong day, but I had to do what I had to do. So I sat down for a few minutes, and this lady called me up, separate from the college program kids, because I'm an adult and I'm working a full-time job here. And she went over this packet. I had to, before I came in, they had sent me an email with this packet of new employee hire stuff I had to fill out. Basically, it was a more in-depth, application with job history and references and, you know, all that kind of stuff. And all the policies that I had to sign. I understand this policy. I understand that policy. A big, huge packet. So we sat down, went through page by page, made sure I had all the right information. And after that was good, she said, go get in this line, follow this guy down. And I found this guy, make sure you have your ID out, and gave this guy the ID. He took me back in the back, fingerprinted me, and then sent me over to this other place to get my picture taken. And then they said, we will call you back in about a week to get you on to the next step. So I thought that the step I was going to would be including the stuff that's going to be in the next step, but it's not. So it's going to be another now week or so before I move on to the next step of actually getting in and doing, orientation, traditions, all that kind of stuff. So I'm just sitting back, relaxing, enjoying life, seeing the sights, and going here to the Character Warehouse. So let's go inside the Character Warehouse and see what we can see.
All right, we're gonna go in there.
I love this picture, Papa.
Yeah.
Good morning, everyone.
I usually come right over here this way first. Warm, cozy Disney apparel. I like how they have this warm stuff right here at the door because it's very cold here right now. You got the Wally ears. Dole Whip ears, those are nice. What do we got over here? This is usually stuff that I like. Tumblers. Yeah, they have that music loud because it's going to catch a copyright claim. They're smart. They know. Nothing new here yet. Haunted Mansion door knockers, those are cool. Those are actually the door knockers. If you go on Haunted Mansion, those are actually right on there. Got the Captain Marvel. Vinyl Mation, Tambourina. What is this? Oh, this is heavy. What is it? G&K Power Droid. Don't know about that. Music is incredibly loud. This is cool. 1,000 piece Walt Disney puzzle. What's the price on that? $8 was 22. It's a good price. Rubik's cubes are still here. And Star Wars stuff. The truck is still here. This is cool. Check out this Santa. It's a lounge fly? I think it's a lounge fly, isn't it? I don't know. Yeah, lounge fly. $46 for a Disney lounge fly. Of course, they always have the headbands. I think I'm gonna get a couple of these. That's cool. Walt Disney World bag. $2. I think I'm gonna get a couple of those. That's gonna be a giveaway item. Reusable Disney bag. I'm gonna swing around this way and try my best to avoid getting direct shots of people. I like that Let's Celebrate bag. I like that. $12.99. Someday, if we get this contest big enough, I can afford big things like that. But right now, I'm just getting small things, like $1, $2 stuff. Nothing else looks new so far. 4-in-1 washable toy soldier. 4-in-1. What does that even mean? Is he changing to different things? I don't know what that means. 4-in-1. I'm trying to read the instructions, but they're all in another language. Disney Parks, Merry Christmas. I don't know. Alright, well, so much for that. Check over here. Disney accessories. That's cool. Like this little change purse. Looks like the phone booth and the stuff like that. I would consider getting something like this, but how would I ship that? Like, if you won this, it would break if I put it in a box. If I put it in bubble wrap, or like a folder, a manila envelope, and flattened it, then it would be flat. And I just, that's a perfect price. That would be something great to put in as a prize, but I just don't think it would, I don't think it would ship well. Disney Cruise Line, what is that, like a bottle opener? Oh yeah, it's like a bottle opener. I think, I don't know. Not much interested in cruise line stuff. Walt Disney keychain. a little Eve. I don't know, little mini ears, little Mickey ears. Well, that's like Jack Skellington. He's even got the tails. It's just a little foam thing. It's tiny. It's a little foam thing. Is that really worth $1.99? I don't know. I don't think so. So something like that.
I haven't seen you forever, man. I know, man. I had to go to Vegas. I had to go to California.
That might be a good idea. I don't know. 50 cents for postcards. I might get some of those myself to send to people. $8 for that? Yikes. Okay. A deck of Disney cards. $5 for a deck of Disney cards. Or a copy of Aladdin. Oh, it's not. Oh, it's. It's not actually a. I thought it was like a DVD. It's a notebook. It's an Aladdin notebook for $5. Interesting. Disney Princess coloring book, $6.99. All right. Gotta stop the video for a second because I have a friend who's interested in this Disney baseball cap, this Nemo cap. So it's actually very calm in here. It's very quiet. There are only three cashiers on the register, and there are like two cast members on the floor just walking around helping people, running shelves and such. It's amazing. All right, so we have $3.99 for these pins. I don't know what they normally were, but $3.99. I'll check that out. My wife just traded somebody for this pin in the parks the other day. $3.99. Wow. I think I might get one of these, because even if it doesn't, no one claims it, she likes it. With that, these Happy Hanukkah pins for $6.99. The Aristocats, $6.99. Still got the Rock and Roll keychains, the Rock and Roller Coaster, little Dole Whip magnets. What does it say, Disney souvenir? Oh, these are the Donald Duck. Oops. Donald Duck magnets, $5. Dole Whip Aloha magnets, $5. So I got the Food and Wine pins for $7. What is this? This is different. Is this new? Did they have this? I think they did have this. Lounge Fly pin, $6.99 for that. No, thank you. That's awesome. Usually $17.99. It's usually $18, now it's only $7. Good deal, but I'm not paying $7 for a pin. This is new. What is this? Just like Mary Poppins? That's nice. Limited release pin included. $15.99. It's like a Mary Poppins carousel and it's got a pin inside. That is cool. Jasmine's mixtape. So this actually looks like an old school cassette. This is an old school cassette case. Oh, but it's a pen. Okay. Jasmine's mixtape? What is Jasmine on Guardians of the Galaxy now? So it's just a pen that says Jasmine's mix. And it comes in a full-on cassette, like an old school cassette case. Does it open like one? I can't get it open. Yeah, I can't get it open. I'm not going to try to bust it open. That's pretty cool. That's different. We're new. We have over here Food and Wines. Oh, here's a Lotso. Check it out. Bing Bongs. Not Lotso, Bing Bong. Lotso sweet stuff. Comes in a box, and inside there's a Lotso pin. So lots of new pins here. But, the price is not right. But this stuff is still here. This Chernabog pen, $5.99. It's a Nemo pen, $6.99 for the Star Wars reversible double wide lanyard. That's cool. This bag is cool, the Christmas bag, big bag, 12 days of socks, that's nice, 12 days of socks, I don't see an old price, but now it's $9.99, Alaska Cruise stuff I'm not much interested in. I did like that Aloha Dole Whip hat. Leader of the club. Oops. $19.99 was the retail price. I don't know what the price is now. I don't see a price. Anything else fun to look at? Magical place on earth. kids' clothes. I don't look much at clothes because, I don't know, it's hard to find something that you can get for someone in their size. Pop Fresh popcorn box, what is it? Shirt, it looks like. T-shirt. Alright. I think I'm going to get one of those big blue bags.
Alright, party people. That's going to do it for today. If you are interested in this contest and this nice merchandise that I just picked up, be sure to go back and watch my previous videos. Find out how you can help get this contest started and how you can get involved in the contest. And remember, Wasio Nahoku is Swahili for they who have no fear. Hurry back.